your spirit, Jesus spirit, God spirit, Holy Spirit has become one spirit.
Hello and very welcome to a very funny TV program. You see a person here in a nightie, in a nice Indian nightie. You will find out why I have decided to wear the nightie to do this program. But you know, there was something very much burning on my heart, which I believe it will be a great help for your life. It will be a great blessing for your life. See what I'm doing here today. We have beautiful little puppy dogs, baby dogs, very cute, cute, cute ones this time here in our camp in Pune in India. We had 30 baby dogs. People are asking me why you allow so many baby dogs. I'm answering them, sorry, they don't ask me for permission if they can procreate or not. But actually they are very obedient, you know, because the word of God is telling that we should be fruitful and we should multiply. So our animals are very, very obedient in that. And here we have such sweet, cute little baby puppies. Now it's very nicely trusting me, enjoying my lap and enjoying me, but I already prepared this needle here for it. It doesn't know what is going to be happening very soon now. But you know, I want to explain to you why we are doing this procedure here. Last year, in the same time, we had also around 30 baby dogs in our garden. And we were too late in giving the injections. Before we could give the injections, another male dog had come from outside with distemper. I don't know if you ever heard of distemper. I had not heard of it, but it's one of the most horrible things you can imagine. All our baby dogs, because they didn't have a good immunity, one by one, they got very horrible symptoms. It attacks the central nervous system, so they got fits and foam from the mouth, and it attacks the intestines, it attacks the lungs and everything. It was extremely horrible. They got symptoms and we tried our best to help them and we could not. We even put the drip, the IV injection and everything, but we could not help any of them. It was extremely horrible. We have only one survivor from it. So now we are very fast with doing our injections, which is a vaccination. And when I was just thinking and praying on how to do these vaccinations, I just wanted to use this to teach you things about your own life and things about the Word of God. This here will not be very comfortable for the baby in this time. See, this baby doesn't expect and doesn't know that I will pinch it now and I will put this. Actually, it's a disease, you know. This is the same virus that could attack and kill this baby. This is actually a disease, but the body will receive it and will work with it and will prepare immunity. You know what the Word of God says? The Word of God says, if you abide in my word, Jesus says, then you are really my disciples. If you abide in my word, you are really my disciples. How many people think they are Christians, they are believers? But actually Jesus says, only if you abide in my word, then you are my disciple. And then he says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Amen. So what we are doing here is we are giving an injection, like an inoculation, like a vaccination. And I tell you, the truth of the Word of God is exactly like this vaccination. It's an inoculation with the truth, so that once the lie comes, it cannot kill you. It cannot attack you. We were too slow with giving this little uncomfortable injection to the puppies. And when the lie came, when the disease came, when the problem came, when the virus came, it finished off all our puppies. We could not help them because we came too late. See, the Word of God is exactly the same thing. In the good time, in that time, you take that discipline. You sit down, you read your Bible. You listen to your Bible MP3. You can put it on your cell phone. You can put it wherever you go. You can take the Bible with you. Please, you need to inject yourself with the truth. Why? Because the lie will become stronger and stronger. Jesus said, in the end times, there will be many false prophets. There will be many, many false teachers, many false apostles. Many people will come and they will say they're coming in the name of Jesus. And they will tell you many, many things that sound so nice and look so good. They will even do mighty miracles. But you know why? Because the Antichrist will come with lying and deceiving miracles. And Jesus says, if it were possible to deceive even the elect. Did you know that you are an elect one? It likes my message. See, it's deeply looking into my eyes, this puppy. It likes the truth message. Hallelujah. Jesus says, if possible, the devil will try to deceive even the elect. You know, the Apostle Paul says there will be a time when people don't bear anymore the truth of the Word of God. They don't want the truth anymore. And they will give their ear to fables. They will like to listen to some stories and some other kind of thing. And they will heap up for themselves teachers according to their own desire, according to their own itching ears. That is for believers. That is for the body of Christ. And I have to tell you, I see it too much. I see it too much happening in the body of Christ, that believers, instead of listening to the Word of God, instead of really getting the Word of God deep into their spirit, listening to it, obeying it, instead of that, they listen to all kinds of nice, interesting stories. Please don't be like that. See, when I give this injection to this sweet puppy, now it is looking at me such cute big eyes. It's very, very much trusting me, very sweet, very, very nice. In that moment, when I pinch it, it will not like it. But this injection will save its life. It will protect it from destruction. Just exactly like the Word of God. You know, the Bible says, one time Ezekiel and one time the angels in Revelation, they were told to eat. John was told by an angel in Revelation, Apocalypse is in Spanish, Revelation. In Revelations, he was told to eat the scroll, to eat the Word of God. And in the mouth, it will be like honey. First, wow, it's tasty, but it will make the stomach bitter. You know, when you eat and swallow the Word of God, it will be some bitterness. There will be some things that you don't like. You don't like to obey it. Or also, maybe you just understand what God wants and you see so much lie in the world, so much deception all around you, how much people are trying to cheat and to steal and to just destroy humanity. Maybe that is also one thing that makes your stomach bitter. Bible says righteous Lot was torturing his righteous soul when he saw the bad behavior of the people around him, Sodom and Gomorrah, imagine. So he was torturing his righteous soul by seeing the bad behavior of all the people around him. So maybe this will happen to you. But I tell you, this truth injection, this injection of the Word of God, that will save your life. It will save your life. It will save you and protect you from destruction. So now I will show you what happens when you have to give such a truth injection. It will be a shock for this poor little puppy, but it will save its life. Sweetie, don't worry. I will pinch you, but it's for your good, okay? Nobody wants to believe that. You know what the Bible says in Hebrews? No discipline is in that moment pleasing to a person. It's always painful when we have to give some discipline. But then it will give the peaceable fruit of righteousness to those who are used to it, who are exercised in it. Sweetie, you didn't cry. Wow, what a nice puppy you are. Very good. See, it could nicely bear it now. Some of them were crying and screaming. This one was licking me. See, I think, do they understand English? This one would have understood that we just saved his life. Sweetie, we bless you. Have a happy, healthy life in Jesus' name. Amen. So, did you see? It's not that difficult to be vaccinated and to be inoculated with the truth of the Word of God, with something that in that moment might make your stomach a little bit bitter, but you will be exercised. Your senses will be exercised to discern between truth and lie. Your senses will be exercised to discern and to rightfully use the power that God wants to give you. Hallelujah. Sweetie, bless you. See, look at this one. See, it is not upset with me. I gave it the truth. You know, sometimes we are scared. Sometimes we are worried when we need to speak the truth to somebody, because we don't know what will this person do if I speak the truth. What will this puppy do if I give an injection? You know, if we have to give injection to the grown-up dogs, to the adult dogs, now I started doing it. Because when I do it, they don't bother. Maybe they just look, they do like that. They look at me, but they will not bite me. But if you call a vet, if you call a veterinarian to do that, the dog will make a very big fuss. He will scream and shout and jump. One dog broke the window and escaped from the room where we had him. And the veterinarian himself will also be afraid. So he, you know what they do in India? They put the the head of the dog into a sack, into some sack, and they bind the mouth just to avoid being bitten. And then they say the owner of the dog has to be with you so that the dog will not be afraid and will not bite. But still the dog comes into very heavy panic. So I have found out it's much easier when I do the injection. See, did you see any problem here? You know what I want to tell you with that? If you know your God, if you love your God, if you have started to trust your God, even when the truth hurts you, you can accept it. Even when the truth is not tasty for you, you will obey it because you know it comes from a loving person. Amen. So if you need to correct somebody, if you need to tell the truth to somebody, you might have to do it and you know the person, it will be hurt. Sweetie, bless you. Oops. Oh, you, good morning. You know the person will be hurt. Oh, what a giant. Hello, puppy, what a giant you are. You already know the person will be hurt. You know the person might retaliate. The person might be very upset with you. The person might hate you. You know that. So what you should do, you try to show that person that you do it out of love. That you do it because you like this person, because you love that person. You explain to them why you are warning them. Because you don't want them to be destroyed. One example, homosexuality. I had to teach them that in our schools here. You don't know the torture, the torment people go through, the horrible lifestyle. How many broken relationships, how many broken hearts. Did you know that actually even violence, domestic violence, is much higher both in two men, males and two female, supposed to be couples? Did you know that? Even domestic violence is much higher than in a man-woman relationship. We normally think, these men, they can be very cruel. Oh, men don't understand women and whatever. But actually, the opposite is the case. Actually, God made it in such a wise way. Just think about it. See, two males together, can they have babies? Two females together, can they have babies? God made it in a very wise way, no? The two men together is like this. Just a very superficial touch. Two women together, the same. How can they come together? How can they really, not only sexually, in every area, how can they really meet together? But men and women, in all their differences, when they come together, back, they can beautifully interlink. And they will be very strong together. There will be one unity. So it's a very, very big difference. See, two men together is like this. Two women together also like this. Men and women, as they are so different, they interlink. So it's just our wise creator's beautiful design. Amen. So I will just give the next truth injection to this little one here. Bless you. Have a very happy, healthy life in Jesus' name. Come. I'm sorry, sweetie. I have to pinch you. Ouch, 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 ouch. I know it's pinching. I know. I know it's pinching you. Very nice puppy. Beautiful puppy. Very good you did. Hallelujah. See, the next one that could nicely bear this life-saving injection. Can you bear the life-saving injections of the truth of God, of the Word of God? As I was just preparing for this message, you know, I was thinking about some areas where really just the devil, Satan, the great deceiver, the serpent of old, the Bible says, the father of lies, the one, when he speaks, he just speaks lies. He speaks out of his own. He speaks out of his lies. What he is doing to us. If you look at the world nowadays, even among Christians, born again believers, even among pastors and leaders, there is such a very high percentage of people who take antidepressants, who take medications against depression, mood enhancers, antidepressants, all kinds of things. Is that really needed? What do doctors tell us? Doctors tell us, thank you, bless you. They tell us maybe it's an imbalance, it's a chemical imbalance in your brain. And they tell you that you need some kinds of substance. Upsa, come sweetie. Thank you. Come cutie, Upsala. Next beauty here. The doctors will tell you that you have some chemical imbalance and that you need some kind of medication to make you happier. You know what I read just today in my Bible? There was a rich young man. He came to Jesus. He said, Lord, what do I have to do to get eternal life? Jesus told him, you know the laws, no? The Ten Commandments, you know? He said, yeah, all of that I know. I have kept it from my youth. And then the Bible says, Jesus looked at him and Jesus loved him. And he told him, there's only one thing that you're lacking. Only one thing that you're lacking. You know what you're lacking? Whatever you have, rich young ruler, you sell it, give it to the poor, and you will have a treasure in heaven. And then come, take up the cross and follow me. What a tremendous privilege, what a calling, what an opportunity. What an opportunity. Jesus is calling that person to become his disciple. Jesus says, follow me. You know, there was a person, he was so demonized. He was full of a legion of demons. Jesus delivered him when he came running to Jesus. But you know what happened? He wanted to stay with Jesus. He wanted to follow Jesus. Jesus told him, no, you go back to your people. I don't allow you to follow me. I don't allow you to travel with me. You go back and you tell your people the miracle God has done through Jesus. See, he had such a desire to stay with Jesus. Jesus said, you go and evangelize. But this rich young ruler had the opportunity to become a disciple. But you know what my Bible says? But he went away sorrowful, sad and sorrowful. He said, the Bible says he became very sad. First, he became very sad. Then it says, and he went away sorrowful because he had many riches. What a tremendous word, no? He became very sad when Jesus told him, give away everything. And he went away sorrowful. Sad and sorrowful. Two very powerful words. Doesn't that sound like depression? Sad and sorrowful. You know, years ago, already before I was even thinking about that, we were in a pastor's conference in Germany. And the Holy Spirit told me, tell them why they are so frustrated. Why they need antidepressants. Because somewhere they missed the junction. They missed to follow some command or something Jesus told them to do. They didn't do it. They were disobedient to the word of God. So the Lord told me, just tell them, go back, pray, ask the Lord, where did I go astray? Where did I miss? Where did I just disobey? Go back to that point. Do what God told you in that time. And this depression will go, because you will step by step again come into God's will. See what Jesus says. Those who have my commandments and do them, these are the ones that love me. Those who have my commandments and do them, these are the ones that love me. So it's not enough to have his commandments, also you should obey his commandments. Amen. So I'm giving them this injection here. They don't have an opportunity to obey or disobey. But you have this opportunity to obey or to disobey. To obey or to disobey. No discipline is in that moment really nice. Everything is extremely painful, uncomfortable, very bad and horrible. But it gives the peaceful fruit of righteousness to those who have been exercised in it. Amen. So maybe you miss somewhere. And then you know what happens then? God doesn't speak to me. I don't know why God doesn't speak to me. There could be two reasons. One reason could be God says, why should I even speak to you? Anyway, you won't do what I tell you. That's a very serious one. So if that's the case, you really need to repent and tell the Lord, please, Lord, forgive me and bring me again back into obedience. This first step, whatever you showed me, maybe to give the tithe or maybe to be baptized in water, whatever it might be. This one is afraid, see? Whatever it might be, just do that first step. Show him, Lord, I will obey. Whatever I read in your word, I will do it, I will obey it. Show him that you really want to obey from now onward. And slowly, slowly that relationship will come up again. Or maybe you became sad because he told you to give up something. Maybe you walked away very sorrowful. We never again hear from that rich young ruler, you know. I think that many times. You know what my Bible says? Many are called, but few are chosen. Many are called, few are chosen. Why are they not chosen? It's not because God suddenly changed his mind, no way. It's because God gives opportunities. And only when you take that opportunity, when you grab that opportunity, you can step by step walk into your destiny, walk into your calling. Come, sweetie, we'll take a nice injection. Come. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. See, maybe, don't worry. Sit. Come, sweetie, sit. Be nice. Don't worry. In Jesus' name. See, even just this obedience. See, this one was afraid. This one didn't trust me. See, when you're afraid and you don't trust the person who wants to give the injection, when you're not trusting that person, when you're afraid, then there can be more pain when you try to do what you're supposed to do. Sweetie, see, this one wants to run away directly. Okay, sweetie. Okay. Don't worry. Hallelujah. But see, maybe it was not a big disobedience. Can I tell you one thing that happened to me? The devil is a liar and he is a deceiver. And the main problem is he has a lot of time. The devil has a lot of time. Hello, sweetie. I bless you. The devil has been around thousands of years and he has a lot of time. So he will not work on you very fast. He will be working on you slowly, 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 slowly. So for me, he gave me some ideas why I could be sick. Some good reasons why I could really have some dangerous physical problem or something. And so one morning I just woke up and I felt everywhere. And I said, Jesus, what is wrong with me? And immediately inside the Holy Spirit, you know what he said? He said, there's absolutely nothing wrong with you. You can just right now rise up and rejoice. And I understood that that means I can just right now start jumping and dancing and singing and praising the Lord. It came like a picture, no? You can rejoice, like jump and dance and sing for Jesus. He said, there's absolutely nothing wrong with you. You can just right now rise up and rejoice. So, you know, that meant it was even the medicine he gave me. Rise up and rejoice, that's the medicine. Have you heard of Smith Wigglesworth? He raised 23 people from the dead. He's a man from UK, from last century, even 2 centuries ago now. 18 something he lived. Hallelujah! He was born. So he used to get up in the morning and the first thing he used to do is to run around his bed and jump and sing and praise Jesus. And this is the vision I had. There's absolutely nothing wrong with you. You can just right now rise up and rejoice. Amen. And it came so strong into my spirit. I told my hubby, you know, this word, there's absolutely nothing wrong with you. You can rejoice and rejoice because that's the medicine against any bad feeling you have. This word came so strongly that even if anybody would tell me now you have cancer, I would not accept it. Imagine what happened. Right after that, we went to Germany and I don't know what happened there. Something bit me. I was exhausted all the time. Finally, just before coming back to India, I took a blood test and my platelets were very low and many things were out of range. Liver was out of range. Many things was out of range. And there were some cells in my blood that are only supposed to be in the bone marrow. They're supposed to be only in the bone marrow. So when even 2 Christian doctors saw my blood and were very shocked and said, oh, you cannot go to India. You have to stay here. You have to be hospitalized immediately. Oh, that means leukemia. Oh, that's blood cancer. Oh, these cells should never be in the blood. It comes from the bone marrow, some major problem and everything. No. So the attack came. The attack came. This doctor said it means leukemia. Praise God for my Christian doctor lady. She took me into her prayer room immediately, anointed me with oil, and we prayed. And I said, yeah, I refuse it. I don't accept it. Jesus said, there's absolutely nothing wrong with me. I feel horrible. But he said, there's absolutely nothing wrong with me. I can rise up and rejoice. So I reject that. I just reject that. Whatever my blood says, whatever doctor report, I reject that. I'm healed in the stripes of Jesus. And we took another doctor report and another blood test, and it came out better. Not very perfect, but much better. My platelets, you know how I could raise them again? One day I saw the monkeys here eating our papaya leaves, and they just found out for dengue fever, when you eat, there's some tablet of papaya leaf. I saw the monkeys eating them. I said, why should I swallow tablets if we have our own papaya leaves here? So now every day I'm eating my papaya leaf and my blood has become very perfect again. Hallelujah. See, the truth of God had inoculated me, vaccinated me. It had prepared me before the lie of the devil could come. You understand? That's why I want to show you this what I'm doing here. That's why I'm showing you how we are saving the life. See, if I had accepted leukemia, something very wrong, I have to be hospitalized, I have to start taking cancer treatment, whatever, I might be dead by now. But the word of God vaccinated me with the truth of God before the lie could come. Hallelujah. Can you do that? Can you have that in your life? You must have it in your life. Let me tell you another big lie that is happening right now. Have you heard of global warming? Definitely you would have heard of global warming. Now this year, we have a very tremendous heat here. But you know why? The heat here is because we had a beautiful cyclone that has killed, according to the news, 150,000 trees just in our district. When we were traveling, I think it would have been much more. Just in our 4.5 acres land, we had over 40 trees that fell down. But praise God, we lifted them up again and they're beautifully coming again. They're beautifully bringing new fresh green leaves again. Hallelujah. But this heat will come if you cut the trees. Last year, in an area that's normally not very hot in India, you know what's happened? They cut 500,000 trees, 500,000 trees. They cut them to sell them, to make them wood for fire burning, whatever. They cut these trees. You know what happened? The temperature rose by 3 degrees. People are trying to sell you some scary, fearful news of global warming. Can I tell you, I'm also a scientist. Just I read in the news, it says 97% of the scientists believe in global warming. It's not true. And even 97% is not true, because there are many good, genuine scientists that have come out of that gang, out of that crew, and have said, see, actually we were threatened and we were forced to give even false reports. We were forced to keep our mouth shut and not to give the truth. So there are so many things where just Satan is trying to stifle us and to hinder us and to steal and kill and destroy from our life, from our quality. Did you know they want to kill the cows because cows produce too much carbon dioxide? Can you imagine? Cows are biblical animals. Jesus drank milk and ate curd and all these things. King David curd in the wilderness. We can see so many attacks against the life that God has created for us. If you look at all this genetically modified food and all these things, if you look at the Terminator gene, just Google it, the Terminator gene in the genetically modified things, just study a little bit. My Bible says in the very first chapter, we should procreate according to our own kind. That's what God wants. God needs to inoculate you with the truth of His word so that when the lie comes, you will stand. You will not fall for the lies of the Antichrist. You will become a strong believer. You will stay strong. The truth will set you free. You will know the truth by the word of God, and the truth will set you free. I just bless you with the truth of the word of God, with a hatred for lie, with a love for righteousness, so that you can be anointed with the oil of gladness more than all of your companions, just like your Lord Jesus was. We bless you in Jesus' name.